It is no secret that the cognitive abilities of President Joe Biden have been deteriorating very fast in the past few years. And in this video, I'm going to speculate and point out a two likely culprits of his unfortunate decline: garbage food and a certain medication. And I have these suspicions because of my experience with my mom's decline. But first, let's refresh our memory and let's watch some of the clear signs of his decline.
Yo, it's now long.
Yeah, my mom does that many times. Just freezes and look at you with that lost face.
Terry Vilsack, Senator, excuse me, I didn't go to you. She's all kidding aside, he's doing a hell of a job.
Mr. President, thank you. At the end of such a momentous event, the word thank you seems kind of inadequate.
Of Putin's kleptocracy. Yeah. Kleptocracy. And the guys who are the kleptocracies.
What do you say to Vladimir Putin?
To answer the first question? I'm laughing too. They actually... Well, look, I mean, he has made clear that... My name is Joe Biden. I'm Dr. Joe Biden's husband. And I ate Jenny's ice cream, chocolate chip. I came down because I heard there was chocolate chip ice cream. By the way, I have a whole refrigerator full upstairs. I think I'm kidding. I'm not. Oh, I think it could be, but I hope in God that they're... look, maybe I'm kidding myself, but as time goes on, the voter who is just trying to figure out, as I said, how to take care of their family, put three squares on the table, stay safe, be able to pay their mortgage or their rent, etc., is becoming much more informed on the motives of some of the political players and some of the and the political parties.
And then check this one out, the whispering. My mom does this all the time. It's so creepy. Check this out.
I got them. 1.9 trillion dollars relief so far.
Oh my God, that is really, really like my mom. Unbelievable. Same face, same whispering. It's kind of creepy.
I wrote the bill on the environment. Why would I not be for it?
Okay, so that's his current state. And I said at the beginning that the top two reasons for his decline, in my humble opinion, are garbage food and a certain medication. Let's talk about garbage food and let's review together what President Biden likes to eat.
My name is Joe Biden. I love ice cream.
It's no secret that Joe Biden is an ice cream enthusiast.
You all think I'm kidding. I'm not. I eat more ice cream than the three other people you'd like to be with all at once.
In fact, according to Columbus Monthly, the Biden campaign spent $12,546 on Jenny's Splendid ice cream in 1 year. When you consider that the $12,546 doesn't reflect any ice cream that was in Jenny's, it's pretty clear that Biden's love of ice cream is real. Although Joe Biden identifies as an ice cream guy, he seems more than happy to enjoy any number of treats. As Columbus Monthly noted, if it is creamy and frosty and sweet, Joe Biden is all about it. Indeed, he's been known to stop everything just to grab a milkshake, which is precisely what he did after his North Carolina drive-in rally, according to Business Insider. And on occasion, he's been seen indulging in frozen custard, as he did in 2012. According to his food diary from his 2012 vice presidential campaign, Biden's desserts of choice have included cookies, rice pudding, peach pie, custard pie, cheesecake, coconut cream pie, and an unidentified strawberry treat, to name just a few. In 2016, Joe Biden told Us Weekly that his favorite meal was pasta.
Ice cream is big. Pasta with red sauce, He can go deep on that. Uh-huh.
So it is pretty clear that President Joe Biden has been addicted to junk food, sugar, and highly refined carbohydrates all his life. And I posted a video a while ago about the connection between a diet high in sugar and carbohydrates and dementia and Alzheimer's. So go and check that out. But here's a quick summary of why it's a big problem for our brain. A high carb and sugar diet causes insulin resistance, inflammatory damage to our brain, impaired glucose metabolism in our brain, and it kills ketosis. So, on one side, you are inflicting the damage to all your tissues and the brain, causing the formation of the amyloid plaques. And on the other hand, you are destroying your mitochondria, which cannot metabolize glucose appropriately anymore. And finally, you are depriving your body from a key alternative fuel, your ketones. Okay, garbage food might be enough to explain President Biden's decline, but I think there is an important cofactor that has accelerated his decline because it's interfering with the ability of the body to fight off all the damage he's doing with the diet. And my wild speculation and opinion is that this cofactor is statin medications. Let's check this article from 2017. The president's personal physician has issued Biden a clean bill of health. Look here, he also takes Crestor, a statin medication to help control cholesterol. Also, the report here that his lab work shows his lipid levels are what his doctor described as remarkably low. This is incredible. So his doctor is bragging about the fact that his lipids are remarkably low. I see this as a big problem, actually. Our lipids are very important for our health. The body desperately needs cholesterol as a building block to fight against all the insults that President Biden is inflicting and has been inflicting to his body for all his life. And the statin medication is preventing his body from producing it. Let's check some Crestor side effects, shall we? The most common side effects may include headache, muscle aches, abdominal pain, weakness and nausea. Memory loss and confusion have also been reported with statins, including Crestor. Also, back in 2012, the FDA issued this important safety communication related to the safety label changes to cholesterol-lowering statin drugs. And in particular, among all the issues that they raise, this one is very important. Memory loss and confusion have been reported with statin use. These reported events were generally not serious and went away once the drug was no longer being taken. Okay, since we are on the topic of statins, let's review a couple of more little details here.
Not even 4 hours
that
ago.
That was a quick trip.
So it appears that President Joe Biden stumbles a lot. And you might say, oh, come on, that's normal. He's aging. He's old. But check this out. So check this piece of research in the National Library of Medicine. Association between statin use and balance in older adults. The present results suggest a negative effect of statins on balance control in the mediolateral direction, a direction that has been associated with increased falls risk. Particular attention should be given to the risk of balance loss in older adults using statins. The results suggest that statin use may worsen balance abilities. Or this other one, statin therapy, muscle function, and falls risk in community-dwelling older adults. Conclusion: statin use may exacerbate muscle performance declines and falls risk associated with aging without a concomitant decrease in muscle mass. And this effect may be reversible with cessation. So I'm pointing this out because my mom had the same problem. After taking statins, she started stumbling a lot. She fell many times, and on two occasions, she had to be transported to the ER and have stitches to her forehead. Obviously, all of this is my own speculation, is my own opinion. This is not medical advice. I'm not a doctor. So please talk to your doctor about these issues. I really think they did a great disservice to President Joe Biden and to all of us by prescribing a cholesterol-lowering medication rather than correcting the self-destructive nutrition habits of President Joe Biden. But anyway, what do you think? Are you taking care of anybody with dementia or Alzheimer's disease? Do they eat a lot of sugars and carbohydrates? And do they take statins? Let me know in the YouTube comments below. I would love to know. Until the next video. Bye now.